These are research specimens of migratory birds from the Field Museum in Chicago. These are just one tray of specimens out of more than 70,000 birds that have died hitting buildings in Chicago over the past four decades. A lot of these birds died because they were attracted by artificial light emanating from buildings in Chicago. Many birds migrate at night, and for reasons that we still don't totally understand, the artificial light coming from buildings actually disorients migratory birds and attracts them and leads them to collide with buildings. They fly under the cover of darkness, and we don't see the migration.
Two south, one west. Two more south.
One of the only ways that we can actually watch migratory birds flying at night is with the use of a thermal imaging camera. This allows us to see nocturnal migration in action, but we can't tell which species are involved. Only through listening to nocturnal flight calls can we actually identify these nocturnal migrants to species and begin to learn about who is migrating when. Migratory birds, when they're flying, many of them make these very faint, subtle, high-frequency calls. So what we think is happening is that birds, when they're attracted to light, that they become disoriented and they're flying around, and we think they're actually calling more and making more nocturnal flight calls while they're flying, and that this may in fact attract more members of the same species to the light. Our study is a good example of the impact of artificial light on migratory birds. We show that the more light there is, that the more birds collide with certain buildings. And so by continuing to try to turn lights off at night when they're not needed during bird migration will help to reduce the impact of light pollution on bird mortality.